Hey everybody, so I have a small dresser. My ears look huge. Let me just cover that up. I've got a small dresser that I'm gonna start working on. I'm getting kind of excited. The weather's getting nice, so now I can move on to furniture. So I do have this small dresser, four drawers that it came with, and I'm gonna prep it. So definitely the first step when you redo furniture is you want it clean. You need to make sure it's clean. So I'm just gonna kind of run you guys through what I do with it. I personally like to use Kaboom. You can use a degreaser, mix with some water, whatever, but I like this stuff for a lot of projects. So I'm just gonna spray it on. Just like that. And that's going to turn white, so it's cleaning right now. And then I am just going to take a scouring pad. I'm just going to really get in there. Just make sure if there's any residue, any rusty dirt from the person who had this before. That. I'm going to do the same thing on the top, and I'm going to do the same thing on the drawers. I'm just going to take a dry towel. I'm just going to wipe it down. Voila. I'm going to go back over it with a damp cloth too, but I'm going to finish doing these drawers and then I'll come back in. Now that everything's kind of scrubbed down, we have water mister. You can use water bottle. You can use just a damp cloth, whatever you want. But I'm just gonna wipe these down. Just make sure that Kaboom is off. Okay, so when you paint laminate, a lot of people like to sand. Try not to sand if I don't have to. So if you are painting laminate, you want to get a shellac. Then you won't have to sand. Just paint it all with a really, really good shellac. And then once that dries, you can paint over it. You typically don't want to use a water-based product to do this. You want to use the shellac. However, I use Dixie Belle Boss. This is a water-based product. However, it blocks odor, stains, and stops bleed through. And this particular product works like a shellac. So I do like to use this when I paint laminate furniture. So I shook it up, and I'm just gonna paint. I'm gonna paint everything. One coat of this. It goes on clear, like a whitish clear, I guess you could say. Get that on. This is darker wood too, so if you were doing like a really light color over this, like a white, I would recommend doing two coats of this boss or a shellac. But if you're using a darker color, like I'm just going to do one coat of this. Okay, here's where the fun part begins. So I am going to blend. I'm going to start at the bottom with some black, and then I'm going to work my way up to red. So I kind of want to show you guys how I do that. I'm using my DIY paint for this. This is black velvet. And then I have DIY carnival red. So those are the two colors I'm going to be using. For paint brushes, when I do blending, I do like Paint Pixie brushes. You can order those online through their site. I don't know. I mean, you can tell I've had this one for a long time. I need to order some more. They do sell, what is this? Venably, whatever. I believe I got this one at Michael's. I originally got it as a waxing brush, but after I clean them, I'll use them as paint brushes too. So we will start with the black. So with this particular paint, I have my water mister. This is going to help spread the paint really well and help blend. We're just gonna start with our black. Some people take the drawers out. I guess for me it just depends on the project. Because I am blending, I'm not going to take the drawers out. do want to come down a little more down here with some red. I don't want it just straight across. I'm just gonna spritz that. Going to come back up with the black. Just like that. And you're just going to kind of keep playing with it until you kind of get the blend that you want. So yeah. Mist with water, this helps keep the paint moving. Dry. I'm gonna go in with my polyacrylic mat. Just put the transfer on and now I am going to seal it just with polyacrylic, and then once that dries we'll get into some shading with some wax. So that's all I'm doing right now. Acrylic's dry, so we are gonna go in and add a little shading with some wax. So I have my LAC DIY wax. Don't mind the music, my daughter's jamming out in the bathroom. I think she's dyeing her hair. Anyway, so let's just get this open. I had to order new wax because I used all my other stuff. And then I have my paper towel. and stuff. I love it. It's like creamy, creamy butter. So, because we have the polyacrylic on, when I apply the black wax, it'll be easy to wipe off. So I can leave it in the spots that I want it and wipe it back off the spots that I don't want it. It up just a tad bit. Show you a technique that I like to do on sides of projects just to make this look. I mean, this is nice, it's pretty, and even if I put black wax on it, you know, it'll shade it kind of bit. But I'll take my sandpaper. This is just 120 grit. I'm just gonna rough this up a bit. Right? Took off some of that holly. And then we're gonna go back. And what this is gonna do is it's gonna give it more of a worn, distressed kind of look once I apply this black wax. Yes, I should be using a bigger waxing brush, but it's upstairs. And I don't wanna go upstairs and get it. This was not part of the plan, but this is the fun thing about furniture. You just kind of go with it. You just look at a piece, and you just go with it. Do what your gut is telling you to do. It's fun. Don't overthink it. So many people overthink projects and furniture. Just have fun and just listen to your gut. Like right now, I'm still debating. I'm kind of thinking maybe I'll add even a little gold leaf in with some of these flowers. I don't know. Possibilities are endless. All the way down to the bottom. Yes, I use a lot of wax too. Probably don't even need to use this much, but. That's okay. That's how I roll. Okay. Here we go. Oh, isn't that delicious? It's delicious. I love it. I like it a lot. So yeah, wax takes 48 hours, well, 72 probably, just to fully cure. I like to leave them for 72 hours to fully cure. And then once that's done, I will go over it with my buffing brush, or you could use a rag too, and just kind of buff out all these little wax lines and whatnot. So you guys see the detail on that?
Isn't that yummy? Yum, yum, yum. Yeah. I like it. Okay, so I did decide. I couldn't help myself. I had to scruff up different areas, kind of like I did the sides. And then went a little too far right there. That's okay, I'm fixing that. But I did decide I am going to go ahead and add just a little bit of gold leaf. Just a tiny, tiny, tiny little bit. So I ordered my gold leaf off of Amazon. It's very, very thin. Thin, thin, thin. There's copper and rose gold in there too. And I'm just going to take my tape wand, quick and thick. Not doing a lot of gold leaf at all, like just a teeny tiny little bit. And I was thinking like centers of the flowers perhaps. Take out some of my gold leaf here. Yeah, it's very, you definitely don't want to use this if you got a fan going or if you're outside and it's windy. So off a little piece of my gold leaf. I'm just going to tap it on, just like that. I'm not going to do anything or touch this until it's dry. Okay, so just a dry brush. Just gives it a little something.